Hello again. In this lesson we will discuss how to load data into Data Grid View Control from SQL Server database table. And you can see an example in here. We have this WinForms application with a form, and when we load this form it loads the data into our Data Grid View Control. So we will create this application in this tutorial. So now go to Visual Studio, create a new project, select Visual Basic, then Windows, and finally Windows Forms application, and I will leave the default name as it is, and then click OK. This will create this project for us. Now the first thing we need to do is to set a few properties of this form. Just go to the properties window. Now we'll change the text property to employees info. And I want to disable this maximize button, so just make maximize box property as false. Also want when the form loads it should load in the center of the screen, and I also want that the form should not be resizable, so I will make it fixed single. So that's all we need. The next thing I need to do is to go to the toolbar, and in the data panel, as you can see, select Data Grid View Control, and I will draw it on this form. That's all we need to do. And afterwards, to change the name of this Data Grid View Control to Employee List Data Grid View. Now what we want when this form loads, it should load the data into this control. So how to do that? Generate the form load event, and what we need to do is for this data grid view control define the data source, which will be a function which returns data table. So how to do that? Employee list data grid view, and then data source where the data is coming from, and it's coming from a function called get employees list. And now we need to define that function, and private function get employee list, no parameter, as data table, because it will return data table. That's all it is. Sorry, employees. So now you can see. So now what we need to do is to define a data table in here. So DT employees as new data table. And then return that data table. So now what we have done, we have declared data source as function which returns a data table. We then define a data table which is returned by this function. But currently this data table is empty, so what we need to do is to define connection string first in our app.config file, because we need to get the data from this database with a table. From the table called employees, and we have all this data in here. So what we need to do is to create a connection string first to this database, and then define a connection and give it a name dbx, and then define the connection string, and finally provide a name which is system.data.sql client. Now we need to have connection string. A easy way is to go to Server Explorer, add a connection, select SQL Server, continue, and we need the name of this server. So just click in here and you copy it, put it here, and now you can select all the databases, select that, go to advanced, and just copy this data source from here. That's all we need, and just paste it here. So if you don't remember how to write data source or connection string in the app.config file, just that's the easiest way to find it. Now we have the connection string, we need to use it in our code. So what we need to do is create a string and get the value from the app.config file configuration manager. And you can see IntelliSense is not giving us the options, so the first thing we need to do is to get add a reference. And we need system.configuration. So click OK and then import it here as well. System.configuration. Configuration. And there we go. It's now green, so we can use it. Dot connection string. And which connection? DBX, as you can see. If the name is different, then it will not work, so make sure it's exactly the same name. And finally, dot connection string. The next thing we need to do is to use SQL connection object. So using con as new SQL connection object. And you can see IntelliSense is not giving us this option because we need to import two namespaces. So import system.data and import system.data.sql client. So now you can see it's green and it is asking for connection string. As you can see, so just give it the connection string. Now we need SQL command object, so create an object of it, SQL command, and then define the command text and the SQL connection object. So command text is select star from video dot employees, this table, employees table, get all the data from there, and the connection object is gone, as you can see in here. Then press enter, and that's it. Now we need to open the connection and then we need to use SQL data reader to get the data from the database table. So create an object of it, SQL data reader, and we will use execute reader because we are using select statement. So execute reader. Now we need to, now we have the data, so we need to fill or load that data into this data table. So employee.load and load the data into data table. So now we have the data. If we run our application now, you will see the data is loaded into our data grid view control. So now the first thing we need to remove, now we need to improve this application a bit further. You can see this empty line in here or empty row in here. To remove that, just go to the design, click here and uncheck enable adding, editing and deleting. So now if you go there, there is no empty row anymore. Now the next thing I want is that the data is filled across this data grid view control and it should remove this scroll bar. So how to do that? We select the data, the control, and we will change auto size column mode property, which is currently none, to fill. So now if you run the application again, and you can see the scroll bar is gone and the data is filled in this data grid view control. Next thing we need to do is, I want, when I click on any row, it should select the complete row like this rather than a cell. So how to do that? Just select the control and make selection mode property as full row select. So now if you go, you can see the full row is select when I click on it. If I try to select multiple record, which I can do, but I want to select one record at a time. So how to do that? Just go to multi-select property, which is currently true. Just make it false. And now I can't select multiple record in this data grid view control. So as you can see, it's so easy to load data into our data grid view control in Windows Forms application. So with this, I conclude this video. Thanks for watching.